Hey guys, so it's me back. I'm back. Amber Helena here. A big apology to what's been going on the past month and stuff. I know I haven't really been keeping up to date with my videos, and I have a whole bunch of reasons why, not excuses. It's just been a lot of things going on, but if you follow me on my Instagram, I have been trying to post up like little things I've been buying and things I use, and people do still ask me questions on there, so I've been answering makeup questions and all that. So with that being said, I'm sorry, and I just want to say a big thank you to all the new people who have subscribed to me, and that means a lot to me because I haven't been posting, and with that being said, you know, you lose followers. So today's look is going to be a spring, fresh, clean look. It's definitely wearable every day. It's soft on the eyes, and this look can pretty much go with any kind of skin complexion, and yeah, it's super easy to do. It didn't take me like a whole bunch of time, but yeah. So I hope you guys like it. Just keep watching, subscribe, like, and comment at the end. Tell me what you think, what you want to see, and I'm going to try my best. I'm not going to make a promise this time because you never know what comes up, but yeah. So I hope you guys like this look, and just keep watching. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to use is the Urban Decay eyeshadow primer potion. So I'm just gonna put that on my finger, and I'm just gonna put that all over my eyelid and put a generous amount, not too much. I have oily eyelids, so I can't like overdo it with, you know, primers and stuff, even if I put a shadow on top. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just put this all the way up to my brow bone too. And I like to do a tapping kind of motion, so that way there won't be any patches or anything, because it tends to do that sometimes. Okay, now I'll go in into my chocolate bar palette, and I'm gonna take that lightest shade up there, and I'm gonna actually pack that on all over my lid, because if you put your primer on, your eyeshadows blend out a lot easier when you put a nude eyeshadow on top. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just do that. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take our blending brush. This is my MAC 224. We're gonna take this blending brush, and I'm gonna go ahead and go into my BH Cosmetics 120 color palette eyeshadow. This is the fifth edition, but right next to this black shade is this like kind of burnt brown shade. So yeah, so I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna take that and I'm gonna dip it with my blending brush. And anyway, so you're gonna go ahead and just start buffing this in into your crease, and you want to kind of hold it down like this. So can you guys see what I'm doing? Okay. So I'm kind of holding it up like this, and then kind of blending it out like that. And if you want, if you don't like rounded shapes, you can always kind of extend it. So just go like this and kind of just dash it out a little bit or whatever. So I'm gonna go back to my chocolate bar palette, and I'm going to take, I'm gonna use this shader right here. It's right under kind of like this weird grayish green. So I'm gonna go with it. This is the first chocolate bar palette, by the way. I wasn't cool enough to get the second one, so it's okay though. So I'm gonna actually blend this on top of what I just did. So, because I want it not to be so dark, I still want it to be kind of diffused and lighter. And I'm actually gonna buff that a little bit above the blended thing I just did. So I'm going to go in back to the chocolate bar palette and I'm going to take this dark brown right there. And if you haven't noticed, I'm leaving the lid untouched so far because I'm gonna be placing like a very fresh tone light color on top. And it's okay if it's not 100% perfect because I usually do go in and clean it up with some concealer to just perfect it. And then I'm going back in with my blending brush and I just kind of wanna diffuse it. If I'm not mistaken, I believe this is the Vice 3 palette. You can see all my fingerprints, but whatever. So I'm gonna take the color Last Sin and I'm going to pack that on very modestly. So I'm gonna actually go back in and I'm gonna take this color again. Excuse my nails, but. And I'm just gonna buff that in into my crease. And I'm gonna take the pigment that's in here. It's right next to that shade I just used. And I'm gonna use it with my finger. And it's a beautiful, you can see it. It's just really pigmented and just really nice. So I'm gonna just pack it on, mostly in the center though. And just go back in and just start cleaning it up again. I'm going to, right after I finish, I'm gonna do a wing liner so you guys can see that. Yeah, I'm gonna start lip lining my lip. And I'm going to just overdraw them slightly on the Cupid's bow to give it some definition. So now I'm gonna use my Sephora lipstick. This is like my favorite nude lipstick because I cannot put certain nudes on my lips because I look like a ghost. Like I look chapped and nasty. And this one's called Ingenuous. I think I pronounced it right this time. And I used this before in my video too, but I think I said Ingenious, so yeah. So I'm gonna go ahead and just fill the rest of my lips in with this. Okay. Lastly, I'm gonna go ahead and add a little bit of a clear gloss. I got this from Forever 21 and I had this for such a long time and I love it when I'm wearing something matte and I want a little bit of a plump to it. So you're just gonna put a little bit of this to the center of your lips. Your lips. Yeah. Ugh, a lot came out. Or just put it all over. So this is the final look. It's very neutral on the eyes and I feel like this is such a, you know, common thing that you guys can wear. It's definitely wearable every day and it's just a color that can go with anything you really wear because it is neutral and it isn't so heavy on the eyes and it's so simple to do. I don't think that it was really that difficult and I do try to do looks that are doable for, you know, you guys. You guys are my family and yeah. And I hope you guys like this. Please subscribe, comment, and like at the end. Tell me any suggestions or ideas you have or something you thought I should have added. Once again, you don't have to do exactly what I did or use any colors I did. This is just something that I just decided to do. So yeah, also follow me on my Instagram, amber.helena, and I have my personal Tumblr or Twitter or whatever you guys want. Feel free to follow me on there and ask me things there too. So have a great day and I hope you enjoy.